Let's move on and talk about the FMCG pack. Clearly, that's the sector which has been impacted the most on account of fears of GST disrupting their business in the near term. And even Baba Ramdev's Patanjali Ayurved is not spared. In fact, we understand that it is seeing a massive drop in sales ahead of the GST transition, with only 50% of its April-June quarterly target being met. We also learned that it is in the process of planning a massive warehouse rationalization at a national level. Priya Sheth pretty much has this exclusive access to Patanjali. She's been getting us periodic updates. But Priya, what have you learned? 50% is the hit for Q1?
Well, you know, just like several of its FMCG peers, we understand that Baba Ramdev's Patanjali Ayurved is seeing significant pressure as far as sales are concerned. In fact, we do understand that it has achieved about 50% of its quarterly targets. That's in the April to June quarter. Do remember that Patanjali works with a target, an annual turnover target. And this time around for FY18, it stands at about 20,000 crore rupees. So therefore, as far as the April to June quarter is concerned, we understand that sales have been hit primarily because of the transition as far as GST is concerned. We do understand that several of the retailers and trade partners are destocking at this point in time, and that's really led to the decline as far as sales go. But, you know, as far as the pricing is concerned, many of the Ayurvedic products as well as personal care, including shampoos, have come in the higher tax slabs, and that's really going to impact prices for the products. But we do understand that Patanjali will not take price hikes immediately. They will wait for 2 to 3 months before, you know, prices stabilize, and then they would perhaps look at considering taking price hikes. More importantly, the costs as far as the GST regime could increase by about 5% for Patanjali with the new taxes coming into play. But of course, as far as warehousing is concerned, that's where they look at saving up on a lot of costs. In fact, we do understand that they are planning a central warehousing model where they will look at rationalizing several of their warehouses. So therefore, we do understand that as much as 25% of warehouses would remain at the end of the whole rationalization process, and that would help Patanjali save costs going forward. In fact, we did write to Patanjali, and the company said they will be reverting to us very shortly.
All right. Thanks so much.